Before I get to my next project, which is a YouTube commentary, I just want to make an update about my future of this channel and about my commentary. In case if some of you don't know, I made a commentary in September on Jack Stevenson on his commentary on Animant's reviews of Ratchet & Clank, the movie. And my commentary wasn't really the best. I was originally going to re-commentate on him again, but after seeing this commentary on me, there's really no point of commentating on him again. But I'll get to that later. I should show you the commentary that I did. Now, this commentary was almost a year old. It was uploaded on September 13th, 2016. So if any of you guys are gonna ask questions about this, well, this video is really old, so there's really no point of you looking back on it. If you want to look back on this commentary, go to Jack Stevenson's commentary on me, Loneliness Can't Be Horrendous, which is his title on his commentary on me. Now, I'm just going to put this out of the way that I didn't make this commentary because I was lazy. I only made this commentary because I was assuming that his commentary on Animat of his opinions might be the reason why his commentary was so disliked it. And just to point this out, he completely disbanded the comment section, so I really can't show you any of the comments, and besides, I don't think he doesn't want anyone else to see his comments anymore. But my point is that I made this commentary in order to prove something, that what he did was wrong. However, during that time, I had very low interest in making videos. I mean, before that, I made 2 rants on Human Princess Twilight and made 3 reviews of the Equestria Girls movies. And then this happened. You see, I only had 1 idea for today, and then I just go along with it. Now, I did have ideas, but I didn't make a script about it. I'm just going to point this out that almost all of my videos are not scripted except the fanfic ones. Yes, I do not use any scripts. I completely talk on my own unscripted. Why? Because I pretty much know what to say on a point of what I'm going to do. I mean, sure, it won't make a lot of views and a lot of likes, and I might contradict myself, but I didn't contradict myself a lot over the past couple months after I made my commentary. And also, I should talk about editing. Why? Well, he commented on my thought part about me recording in front of my computer screen, and he does have a point. However, I'm not saying that I don't have one in order to do that kind of stuff, and he said, if you don't have one, get one. That's what he said in this commentary. I just couldn't know how to function the entire editing software stuff. What do I mean by that? It's because I don't know all the editing tools to work how to make a video. Now, in school, I try to, but unfortunately, it only allows us to do minimum of what we're going to do in editing videos. I was really in a very low graded class, and I really didn't learn all the stuff like Windows Movie Maker or Sony Vegas or any of that kind of stuff. But my point is that the editing software that I have really isn't a lot. And he did make a point about me not using little of editing software on the app that I've been using. But I really got little ideas on how to edit videos or any of that kind of stuff even more. Also, I will admit that his commentary on me was better than his original commentary, and he did a decent job on his opinions. However, the biggest problem is that he uploaded in June of 2017. Yes, I'm not kidding. Now, I don't blame him on that because he has college and he has a lot of stuff to do. Especially that he was making other videos except this one. Now, the major problem with this whole thing is that he uploaded way too late. I honestly don't blame him for that. I mean, I will understand that he has a lot of stuff to do. But between the time of my commentary and this commentary, I pretty much learned my mistakes. I mean, the editing software that I have, I just basically edit out the stuttering and stuff. And the retakes, I did some retakes on the commentary, even though they were really poor and stuff, but I still try my best to explain the details of what I'm going to say. I always try that for every single video, even if all my videos really didn't get a lot of likes. And I should probably talk about the future of this channel. I'm just gonna point out that nothing is going to change. I mean, yes, the quality will be way better and I can download more stuff recently, but the issue with that is that my family is really poor. Not like extremely poor, but still poor. And not only that, even if I did have all that kind of stuff, the copyright system would be so annoying that I would still use the still images of what I'm going to show you and what I'm going to review. And if I ever going to play a clip, I'm going to have the screen go black and have text on it. I know it's not an easy way to get more views, but I'm sorry. Copyright is so ruthless. And not only that, nothing is going to change because I won't be able to have a lot of videos to be uploaded fastly. I mean, sure, it won't make your life easier to get more subscribers and getting a lot of money if you have a Patreon account, which I don't, but it still won't make a difference. Yes, I know, making videos is supposed to be difficult, but that doesn't mean that I should really have all the time in the world to make a lot of videos. I mean, I will do it, but it's not gonna be pretty soon. Now, some of my videos, like my Sugar Conway, Skyward Sword, Silent Realm, Funny Moments, I didn't have anything to say, and I do know how to download stuff. If there's one thing that I learned about his comment on my thought part, my commentary, is that I can easily download stuff easily. I mean, I didn't have any of that ideas in 2016. I had this idea at the end of April, and I made a video of Sugar Conway failing in the Silent Realm. And yes, my editing software has a way for me to record my lines during one of the videos. However, it will probably take a long time because I have to say what I'm supposed to say at the right time, which is a very difficult thing to do. Anyway, I can understand that Jack Stevenson wants to put more quality on making a video, not just on his opinions, but also the entire video in general. But I really don't have a lot of editing software to do it, and I can't afford it. I just don't want to waste a lot of money. I mean, I did have a lot of money after graduation from high school, but I'm saving that money for later. Now, is this channel gonna change in a couple or several years? I don't know if it's gonna happen pretty soon or next year, but it won't happen anytime soon. Okay, I should finally talk about my recent commentary that I'm going to make. It's gonna be a commentary on Daniel 5, and it's gonna be the infamous ink prank. Now, I know that this video is 3 months old, but so far nothing has changed except that only Daddy and Mommy, which is basically the people who is making the channels, are completely in Mommy 05 right now. Yes, there's another channel, but unfortunately, Daddy 05 is still not uploading any videos right now. So, I'm assuming that him and his wife are completely doing stuff on his own right now. And even though that, of course, the ink prank is old now, but I'm still making a commentary on him because I also want to make a rant at the end of the commentary about faking and staging this kind of stuff because I want to talk about stuff like Majiga Nuggets and Angry Grandpa and possibly Waffle Pump because they're also the ones who inspire people to do stuff like this. However, unlike those channels, Dayo 5 does abusive stuff. And I'm gonna tell you right now that the video that I'm gonna be commenting on has a lot of abuse. And I'm gonna have a warning on that at the beginning of part 1 and part 2. You will find out why I make that commentary. And the last thing that I'm going to talk about is that Baseball Sound, one of my subscriber fans, has an idea to do a crossover on the review. I'm not going to spoil on what we're going to do next in the crossover, but I'm just going to point out that it's going to be an episode, not a movie. And I'm still working on that. I mean, we are going to do a script, but I'm going to try my best to have the script be much better and not have a lot of grammar mistakes. Yes, I do sound gibberish most of the time, but at least I try my best to have the video continue and do my best to have my words at least make sense. Anyway, that's all I have to say. Sorry that this video was all over the place, but I really want to explain a lot of stuff and what's going to happen when I do my return. I'm still working on my schedule during the school year, and yes, there might be stuff that be taken out, but then again, even if I did my ideas back then of not using any scripts on what I'm going to do next, I still had the idea of doing them in the future. I mean, time can be a while, like my Equestria Girls revisits next year, but it won't be anything different because I still have all the time of the world to do that kind of stuff. Even though that time could eventually end in the next 2 years or so. Anyway, that's all I have to say. I'm Lonely Fanboy Foy here, and I'll see you in my next commentary.